Suki is here joining us today, by the way. She's right there. Yeah, as I said in that cringy intro, welcome to my channel. My name is Rebecca. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Hope you're well and dandy and life is going fairly well, if not exuberantly well, and you just can't handle how good it is. Let's have a look at Angelina Jordan. Obviously, check the links down below. I've got and my playlist for singing and songwriting and impressions and whatever else. If you fancy a browse, feel free. Let's get to it. Let it breathe first. So sorry. Bloody Reddit. Let's keep going. Yes. Flipping wow. Chips, mate. Yeah, wow. Before I thought about the technique, before I thought about anything, I thought, good luck, because it's Bohemian Rhapsody and we don't take that song lightly, do we? It's already possibly the best song in the world. No opinions. We don't want to hear it. Yes, no, it's not. No, because it is. And we stan that song ever so greatly. So when someone comes and does something like wants to have their spin on it, we welcome it, don't we? We're somewhat apprehensive of where it can go and how you are going to make it any better or give respect to it. And of course, if you've seen Mark Martel's rendition, hats off, splendid. Watch him. I love him so much. Okay, I'm going to keep going, but I feel like she's having a lot of free reign and fun with this song and an interesting spin to it. I'm loving the fact we can hear her resonance oozing, a very lovely, sensual voice, if I can say that. I know she's young, but that tone is very much, it's like a cross between Amy Winehouse, a bit of Celine Dion, and Billie Holiday. I'm getting those vibes. Interesting. Bit of Ella Fitzgerald. And a way more agility. That's nice. Ah, vocal fry, style it. Sometimes I wish I that's where Simon wants to sign her up. A vintage feel to it. 'Cause nice vibrato. Nice. Delicate. Good, and it's something you don't want to overdo either. You don't want to overdo it, do you? Oh, because you can. You can, and there's lots of things you can do. Doesn't mean we want to hear it. But I feel like she is staying within the... It's hard to explain, like, the decent territory of singing without messing it up and over-embellishments and, like, going so crazy because we can hit the high C or we can hit this note and we can have power. We can... She can obviously demonstrate all these things, but I still think there's a respect of what she's doing and authenticity and really interesting what she's doing, just the laryngeal function to it. She is dampening, she's squeezing at the same time to enhance certain tones that she's creating. She's keeping a space at the back of the pharynx and keeping the soft palate slightly risen, not too much. Diction's fairly good and the emotional core, it got me straight away. I think that's mainly because of the song itself. I like to talk.
Really?
Get it?
Really?
Lower larynx. Pop. Breathe. To Hey, let me just pause. But sometimes, you know, it's like that. And I love Mariah Carey. I love the divas. I would base my life on them. But you know, like sometimes less is more. And sometimes just a nice free straight run. I don't know. I'm just saying. For those who want to then feel like they need to mimic her because of her success. I like her a lot. She's very sweet. Ah, Heidi, yes. Yes, you should stand. Stand forth. Oh, it's all right, that, wasn't it? Yeah, it was. Loving the emotional music they cue on. Good, cut that.
I feel like I am witnessing the birth of something really special, a star, and as they would say in Norway, jeg elsker deg.
See what she did then.
Oh, thank you. I love you too.
Oh. Everything about tonight felt like it came from you.
Simon
Cowell. The arrangement of the song, the simplicity of it. I've never heard that song in that version before. Seriously, this was an amazing
thing. They just love Simon.
Finally, you guys are finished talking. You have no idea how hard it is for me to sit here.
Should love me then.
Jibbity, 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 jibbity,
jibbity, jibbity, jibbity, jibbity. Cue the music. I did. That is amazing, though. Oh, bless her. Yes, you should. Perfectly. What's that? What is that? Let's play it.
Amanda Holden, your favourite Britain's
Got Talent judge
of all time.
Oh, you did an impression. Amanda Holden.
Because clearly, it's not Simon.
Yeah. No, it's pretty good, that impression. Amanda Holden. Yeah, something like that. She is amazing. I've seen her before sing when she was a little bit little. She does have talent, and well done, Heidi, for pressing that buzzer. You never know who's going to get it, do you? And it was nice to see not a sob story at the beginning to, you know, play on our emotions. We don't need that. I feel like almost cut the stories out and just get to the singing because A, I'm impatient, and B, I don't, it's almost like, it's not like I don't care. I just want to get to the singing. I just want to hear you sing. So get singing, the reason you're on there. But, you know, tell the story at the end or put it in a blog post. So she is fantastic. She's amazing. It's just a very warming, very loving performance and respectfully done. And I like her a lot. And she's very pretty and sweet. So she will go far. Absolutely. She's already slaying it as they say. So hashtag never stop singing, hashtag you're never alone, hashtag be yourself, darlings. It's the only way to be. And don't forget to check my Vocal Daily Blast. It's free on my website. There's a few other bits on there as well. Go and have a little look. And thank you for your love and support. You are amazing. You make the world go round. But it's true, you do, because without you, I would be nothing. Working on your voice, keep working on your warming up. Warming up is so important. Do it. Work on your skills, your technique. Stretch your body, stretch your voice. Get yourself out of that and into the world and grab it with both hands like your life depends on it, because you need to. The time is now, it's not tomorrow, and it certainly wasn't yesterday. Bye.